good to go.
Hey, everybody. My name is Rachel, and today I'm going to kind of talk to you about just a general kind of broad topic about why people who have should give. First is kind of like a question of giving to food and what do we give. From Worth Repeating by Bob Kelly, published in 2003, is a quote by Ms. Barbara Bush that says, some people give their time, some their money, some their skills and connections, and some literally give their life's blood, but everyone has something to give. My personal credibility has nothing to do with my wealth or my intelligence or anything of such. It's just that we all have something that we can give to someone else in need or just someone around us, whether it be our time, our money, our possessions, the coat off our back, or some advice, a friend we need. Why we should give. Giving to others is not just an act we bestow on people we're familiar with, but strangers who come in contact with every day. You can change someone's life by just speaking to them or helping them with any kind of thing that they need help with. So one person can give their time, money, or effort to those in need. And I'm going to give you three reasons as to why you should give. Giving is actually good for your health, and it's good for society, and we're commanded by God to give to those less fortunate us from different aspects of our own blessings. So what we're blessed with, we should give back to others, and later on that will in turn come back to us. Giving benefits your health, our first reason. So giving not only benefits the one receiving the gift that you're giving, but it also benefits you. According to Jules Suddy and Jason Marsh on December 13, 2010, in the article, Five Ways Giving is Good to You, from the Greater Good magazine, in a 2006 study, George Mole and colleagues at the National Institutes of Health found that when people give to charities, it activates regions of the brain associated with pleasure, social connection, and trust, creating a one-way effect. In a 2006 study, also from this same source, studied by Rachel Perfrey of Johns Hopkins University, and Kathleen Lawyer of the University of Tennessee, people who provided social support to others had lower blood pressure than the participants who didn't, suggesting that direct physiological benefit of those who give of themselves. Giving benefits society, our second reason. So when someone or you are blessed with much in financial, physical, or emotional regions of your life and aspects of your life, you should give to those who are in need or have kind of an empty spot in those kind of sections. According to Sue Lumines, on September 23rd, 2010, the article, Five Benefits of Helping Others, from Power Essence, with a growing number of people inclined to help others without asking for anything in return, our attitude changes. To be more accommodating, more giving, and more willing to help. This in turn changes the atmosphere around us. So our actions do affect others. So when we give to someone, that in turn, I think, can affect a form of compassion in them to give to someone else. And it kind of just creates this ripple effect. Giving to others shows concern and care for one's community. According to an article written by Muriel Mann in 2017 from GoodNet, scientific research has found that giving creates ripple effect for doing good, encouraging others to behave generously as well. Lastly, we are made to give and to do so accordingly. God has given us much in different aspects of our lives. So we may be blessed with money, we may be blessed with time to go out and just have free time. And some people don't have the ability to do that. But in Romans 12, chapter 12, verse 6 to 8, Paul the Apostle wrote in the Holy Bible, we have different gifts according to the grace given us. If a man's gift is prophesying, let him use it in proportion to his faith. Say, if it is serving, let him serve. If it is teaching, let him teach. If it is encouraging, let him encourage. If it is contributing to the needs of others, let him give generously. If it is leadership, let him govern diligently. And if it is showing mercy, let him do it cheerfully. And so in the aspects of our life where we're blessed, whether it be we are intelligent or we do have a lot of money or we have just the ability to go out and buy a coat to wear in the winter, in those blessings, we should be able to also provide for someone else who can't provide for themselves. And also in Luke chapter 6, verse 38, give and it will be given to you. A good measure pressed down, shaken together, running over will be poured into your lap, for the measure you use will be measured to you. And so even though you give, say I give a coat to somebody, I might not get a coat in return from that person or even someone else. It might not be the same thing that you're giving back. But term in your time that you give to other people, things will be given back to you, and your encouragement and your compassion on other people will be placed on you from someone else later on. And so, giving to all because it is for all. Giving your time, your money, possessions, or even advice to another shows that you cherish the life of another and recognize their need. And so our three reasons going back was giving is good for your health. So you do get some benefit directly from this. Giving is good for society. What harm can come from helping another is the biggest question. And we're called to give according to our gifts and what has been given to us. And what we give will be given to us later on. Call to action. The smallest of things can make the biggest of differences. Anything that could be given should be. And that, you know, that can be from the smallest of things to the largest scale of things. We need to recognize the need, supply the need, and give generously as you are blessed. For it is when we give that we truly understand the importance of those in the world that surrounds us, rather than uplifting our own importance in the world. And so go and give, supply the need of another, and you will see just how much you can be blessed by giving so much away.